Welcome back to Postcards from Home. I'm your host, Erick Gill. I'm here at the Fort Pierce Police Athletic League's boxing facility. I'm here with Coach Izzy. Coach, thanks so much for being here with me today.
Thanks for coming.
How long have you been coaching these students? And
I've been coaching for about 5 years now.
5 years?
5 years now.
Okay. How did you get involved in this? Did you box as a youth?
I boxed when I was a youth and I stopped. And after that, I went to a... got married and let it go.
sure. That's what happens when we get older. We tend to, you know, let those things slide. But talk a little bit about the kids here and where they come from and their skill levels.
Most of these kids are neighborhood kids. Grade levels from eight years old to 18. Most of them are amateurs. I got 4 or 5 of them that are fighting amateur bouts now. I have a female. She's 15. She has talented skills. I got a 17-year-old that's amazing, and up and comers. Yeah. About 35, 40 kids.
Okay, great. And then you've got a number of bags behind us here that so you can work on technique, but also have a ring to actually get in there.
Yeah, that's actually to teach them how to box the right way. Some of the techniques come from inside the ring.
Sure.
We have amateur, not amateur, but practice fighting, boxing matches in there.
Great. How many days a week do they practice?
3 days a week.
3 days a week? Yeah, great.
I have the kids that are actually in boxing bouts and then get into a match, or I bring them all week.
Go ahead.
Well, I see the kids are working out behind us, so can we maybe peek in a little bit and get some footage, maybe talk to some of the students?
Sure.
All right. Okay. Well, Bianca, tell us a little bit about how you got involved in boxing.
Well, I just came in and I didn't even really plan on becoming like a boxer or anything. I just did it because my cousins always told me it was good for discipline, and I just had a time in my life where I was like, I need discipline. So I came in, and then Ralph, coach that passed away, he just saw potential in me, so ever since then I love it.
Yeah, and you know, the last time we were here doing the postcards from a couple years ago, Ralph almost knocked me out, got twice my age, so I bet you learned a lot from him.
Yeah, he taught me a lot, and I'm gonna keep that knowledge forever. I'm so thankful for him.
Great. Now, how long have you been boxing?
For almost 2 years now.
Great. Well, I don't want to hold you up. I'll let you get going stretching and loosen up.
Okay, thank you.
Well, Coach Jack, you got boxing and basketball going on at the same time, right? Now, what age group do you have? Because it looks like these guys are kind of small.
Well, basically, I think he's 7.
Okay.
Correct?
He's 7?
7. His name is Ronnie. And we go up to about 14 or 15.
Okay.
So we have two groups. We have the little kid group, the little team, and we have a little bit of older crowd.
And how often do these guys practice?
We're doing this every Tuesday and every Thursday, 5:30 to 7:30 at the PAL Center.
Great. You do drills too, or is it scrimmage, a little bit of both?
This is mostly fundamentals and basic skills. And we'll probably put a couple of teams together and maybe play some games down the line.
Sure. All right. You want to be on TV? You're anxious. What's your name, buddy?
McCain.
Yeah? What do you like? Do you do other things at PAL?
Yes.
Is basketball your favorite?
Yes.
Yeah. What position you play in? Now don't clam up on me now. You want to be in front of the camera.
He's a good shooter. I can already speak for him.
Oh yeah?
He's a good ball player and a good shooter. And a lot of these kids know how to play, and we're just going to help them along.
What about you? What's your name?
Kenyon Mack.
Yeah? How old are you?
10.
And how long have you been playing basketball?
Two years?
You got some height on it. You the power forward, center? Yeah?
Yeah.
Nice. How many blocks you get a game?
Probably 3 or 2.
We even have a girl or two.
Yeah, nice.
So this is, we got a couple of girls. Uh-huh. I call her B because I can't pronounce her whole name.
Basima.
Basima? That's a beautiful name. Yeah. What position you play?
Well,
you don't know?
We're just working on shooting.
We're working on shooting now?
Yeah.
I saw you sink a couple.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
She's good when she doesn't look at the basket and just throws it over her head. It goes in.
Yeah.
And it's a Snyder.
Hey, Snyder, how are you?
Good. I like that smile. How do you like that?
That is a great smile.
All right.
Is basketball your favorite sport?
Yes.
Mine too. What do you like best about basketball?
You get to show your moves.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a fun team sport, right? Excellent. All right, guys. Good luck. Show me what you got. Nice. See how you hit it? Let's see if I can hit it with a microphone. Let's see if I can hit this with a microphone in my hand. Think I can do it? Think I can hit it? You think I got game? Let's see. I don't know, I'm missing a shot here. Oh, swish. Look at that. Can I be on your team? Can I be on your team? I could be like Dikembe out here. Well, Coach, this is the first year that the PAL has had a football team, or it's been under the Fort Pierce Athletic League. Mm-hmm. Is this your first year coaching?
No, I've been coaching for 20 years.
Okay. You don't look that old. You're keeping in shape, these young guys.
Yeah, they basically keep me in shape.
Now, you've had a great season this year.
We had a real good season. I'm looking for these kids to go farther because the attitude and the aggression and the more they want it. So I'm looking for us to go a little farther.
And what age group are these kids? Because some of them are pretty taller than I am.
They're from 12 to 15 years old. Sometimes they have an older lighter during their birthday run late. So.
Sure. And I know you're missing some kids tonight because the basketball season's already started.
Yeah, Lincoln Park have a basketball game against Jamboree and I believe Westwood. I don't know, but I'm missing a lot of kids. Tonight.
Sure. And then you guys are getting ready for a big game. You won the Treasure Coast tournament.
Yeah, we won Treasure Coast against Boca, a team that beat us prior in the year. It beat us 20-12, but we came back, we put it together and we won 18-0.
And then you're facing, this is now the state?
This is just a regular playoff game. We have the South Championship next week if we advance.
Okay. Well, good luck, Coach, and I'll let you get back to coaching. Maybe Paul Pierce wanted me to put on a helmet and get hit by some of these kids, but I don't think we want to risk injuring an old man.
We do that. Yeah, we got some good hitters in it. We have a lot of good hitters on this team this year.
Yeah, I turned 40 this year, so I want to make it to 50. So.
Oh, there you go.
Thanks, Coach. Right, good luck.
Thank you. You have a nice day.
You too.
All right.
If you're looking for a safe, productive environment for your children, be sure to check out the Fort Pierce Police Athletic League. Located at 903 South 21st Street, the facility features a unique boxing ring, training facility, basketball courts, football fields, baseball fields, and other recreational opportunities. There's even a need for adult volunteers. With the goal of filling playgrounds and not prisons, the PAL facility is open year-round with a variety of activities and schedules. For a detailed list of events and activities here at the Fort Pierce Athletic League, visit their website at fortpiercepal.com or call the staff at 466-0606. That's all the time we have today, but if you'd like to see previously aired episodes of Postcards from Home, visit our website at stlucieco.gov/slctv and click on the video on demand link. I'm your host, Erick Gill. Thanks for watching, and be sure to tune in again next month as we continue to send out Postcards from Home.